So what I want you to notice now is that I traced this image on two pieces of cardboard and I took out this part right here. So I have two pieces that are cut the same. So I once I cut the first one, I used this and I took out that little piece. Then I used this as a tracer to cut out the second one so that they would be identical. And now this is going to go on top. So you can see that this eye is now going to look like it's behind because I'm building up layers. So we're creating a relief. So we really want to build up as many layers as we can. So we really get this very cool three-dimensional piece. And I would, when you're doing the face, I would try and do the whole face. Later on, I'm going to show you some little tricks or tips to build up maybe some of these little things a little differently without having to cut necessarily multiple pieces of that, but that's later on. The other thing I wanted to just note with you here is when I'm doing this, I do notice that I have a little bit of my nose here that maybe needs to be trimmed on the very bottom right here so that it matches up. So I'm going to go in and I'm going to just cut this. Now at this point, it might be helpful if you have saved some of your scraps that you have from your cut cardboard. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and I'm going to start creating this eye, because when you are building your cardboard Picasso face, you always want to start from the bottom and build up. So you're going from the furthest thing away and coming to the front. So when I look at this, my hat is probably going to be last, and actually not even my hat's going to be last. The band on my hat would be last, and any decoration I might put on the hat. My lips may be last. This mustache may be last. So there's different things. So you want to make sure that you're building up. So I'm going to work on this eye, and I'll show you in the next video, and we'll just keep moving on.